good morning.
We will do a little bit of ab work, and we're going to do some standing exercises today. So it'll only be about 5 minutes, and if you can't do the standing, or you don't want to, or you're not ready for it, then you can modify the exercises and still do the workout during that portion. All right, so let's get started. So we're just going to start with a gentle march. We're just going to warm up the body. We're going to bring the arms back and forth. So just swing the arms.
Good morning.
Back as you bring the arms back. And let's just do two more. Excellent. This time let's just bring the arms overhead. So one arm goes up, one arm is down, and continue. So feeling that stretch in the arms as you're doing this one. Continuing to march if you can. Good. Okay, let's bring the arms forward, reaching forward, like we're swimming. All right, let's focus on our legs a little bit more. Let's pick up that pace. So as I always say, please put your own pace to what works best for you. If the pace that I'm going at is too fast for you, then just slow it down. That is totally okay. You need to follow what works for you.
Listen to your body.
Bring the feet wide. Bring them wide and then back in again. So out. And in. Your legs kind of get in the way of the chair and you can't move in the same way. So tapping.
Tapping.
Warming up that body. All right, let's do a toe tap. So tapping the toes forward. And let's just go to a straight march. So really pumping those arms. Alright, let's slow down on the pace of the feet and we're going to bring our arms up. So we're going to bring the arms up to the side, back down, and again. So we're basically doing about a set of each exercise and then we're going to add the weights into it. So you don't have to use the weights, you can continue to do the workout without the weights whenever I pick them up. So if you're just working on range of motion, that is fine as well. Alright, let's bring the arms forward. So working on the front of our shoulders here, this is what, when we start using weight, this is what gives you definition in the front of your shoulders or the front of your arm. Let's do three more. So rest the legs if you need to. Let's do our bicep curls. So squeeze those biceps. So squeeze and down. Squeeze. Let's do four more.
Two. Three.
And one more. Good. Let's bring the arms in front and pull back and press. So pull and press. And four more. And last one. Good. So I'm going to press overhead. So press up and pulling down. So push up and pull down. All the time you are continuing to march if you can. It all depends on what you want to get out of the workout. So if you want more, then just move your feet. Take that break when you need to and then come back and do it again. Let's just do one more. Excellent. All right, rest those legs for a second. We're going to lean back in the chair. Turn my chair so you can see me better. Sitting on the edge, we're leaning back in the chair, flat, bringing the arms up overhead, bringing the arms down, and back up. So working the chest here. So working on our, we want to make sure that we're doing the exercise properly first. We have a slight bend in the elbows. Arms are not totally straight. Forearm, that is the word I was looking for. We're working on our forearm. Because we're going to add the weights later and I want to make sure you have the right form while you're doing this exercise. And last one, excellent. each side. Last one on each side. Okay, let's sit back up. If you can, make your abs do the work. Pull yourself back up. Excellent. All right, let's have our hands down. Think of it having weights here, but we're not using any weights. You're having a string from your elbows to the ceiling. That string is pulling your elbows up. You're squeezing your upper back now. So squeeze and down. Squeeze that upper back and down. Great.
Triceps.
Triceps, the back of our arms here. So kick that hand back. I want you to really concentrate on squeezing right here. So you should, I can even feel that, you know, with the weights, it's working that tricep. So you're squeezing back to the shoulder, squeeze, tighten the back of that arm, and then back to the shoulder. Two more. And last one. Excellent. Alright, let's switch to legs. We are going to do an extension. So bringing that leg up, flexing all the muscles here in your legs. You're flexing, holding, and down. Again, squeeze. And down. Squeeze. So you're working all the ligaments and tendons here in your leg. Strengthening around that knee, which is what so many of us need. Let's do that one more time. And down, switch into the other side. So bring that leg up as much as you can. And down. Down, 40 more. And two more. Last one.
Marching it out.
Okay, so let's do a heel tap and we're going to punch those arms out. So go at your own pace. I know this is a little bit faster than what some of you are used to, so just slow it down if you need to. I try and cater the classes that are the workouts to work for, you know, not everybody, but trying to make it so the different levels of fitness can do the workout. All you need to do is modify the exercises for yourself. Okay, let's go back to march and then bring the arms forward
okay.
And back out. So just bring the hands together and back out. Again, slow it down if you need to.
Oh.
Okay, slow down your coordination here to get the legs moving and the arms moving at the same time. I'm not the greatest for coordinating my movements. Okay, let's have the arms forward and back. So I do this one a lot in my standing classes. I find it's really good for the upper back. So when you bring the hands back, squeeze the upper back. Squeeze. Squeeze. While continuing to march. Okay, let's focus on the legs. Let's pick up that pace a little bit. We can do a bicep curl at the same time. Coordinating the exercises sometimes is really good for the brain as well. Squeezing those biceps. You're squeezing here. You're not just lifting your hands up and down, but you're squeezing. All right, let's do a little bit of a run. Go as fast as you can. Just go your own pace. Ready? And 10.
Come on, go, go, go!
All right, let's bring the feet out. Relax the arms for a minute. So one foot goes out and the other. If you want, you can bring a hand down at the same time to get the upper body into it. Okay, let's switch it up a little bit. We're going to do like a jumping jack. So leg out and arm goes up. So we're just doing singles for now. We're going to switch it up and do doubles in a minute. But
woo, doubles!
Singles if you feel it's too much.
Doubles coming.
Okay, let's do one more on each side. Now let's do doubles. So the back is straight.
Woo.
The back is off the backrest.
I feel like one of those puppets.
One, four, three, two, and one. Good. All right, let's do some glute exercises. So we are going to just sit here. We are going to squeeze our glutes. So I want you to think about tightening your butt.
Squeeze your ass, man!
So it looks like I'm doing nothing, but I am. Squeeze his glutes. All right, continue to squeeze and lift that one foot off the floor. So you should be feeling that all through your legs here, in your glutes, of course, because that's what we're working, so squeezing those glutes. Bring that foot down, relax for a second. All right, now squeeze again. So squeeze those glutes. Lift that up. Squeezing. Bring that foot back down. Let's do it again. Squeeze the glutes. Bring that foot off the floor. And back down, relax. And squeeze. So squeeze the glutes, lift that foot off the floor. Continue to squeeze and hold. Excellent. And relax. Good. Okay, let's pick up our weights. Or not, up to you. I want to definitely have a few exercises that we're using weights because it is so beneficial to get strong. Okay. Let's have our weights down the bottom, or without the weights, whatever you prefer. Let's bring the arms up to the side and back down. Now let's add our calves into it. So when you bring arms up to the side, you're lifting your heels up off the floor. And down. We're going to do three more. And last one. Okay, do the same thing going forward, having your arms in this direction this time. So weights are up and down. So control the lift on the way up and on the way down. Also allow your weight just to kind of fall. You don't want to do that. Control it. And let's do two more. So I want you to bring the dumbbells together, bring the weights down so you feel that stretch, and then push them back up again. So my arms are bent at the elbows just a little bit, and then go back up. Let's work on our abs. So depending on your back, you might need to put the weights down. If you can, just keep the weights at your chest. You're going to lean back into the chair and then make your abs do the work. So tighten your abs and pull back up, breathing out. Going back. And breathing in. And again. Five more. last one. Okay, for the next one, if you have heavier weights, I encourage you to pick up the heavier weights. Our upper backs are strong. So we are going to do what we did before, just with the range of motion. So now our weights are down. We are having a strain from our elbows up to the ceiling. So pulling our elbows up and squeezing that upper back. So it's like you're squeezing a water bottle in between your shoulder blades. So squeeze and go. So squeeze. And slowly lower the weight. Okay, so if you pick up that heavier weight, now I want you to pick up that lower weight again, the lighter weight. So we're in that same position, we're working the back of our arms. So elbows are up, and we're kicking that weight back. Okay, so press, hold, and back to the shoulders. Squeeze the biceps. Back to the shoulder. Squeeze. Sorry, I have to say it because people don't squeeze their arms.
I think you're doing it because you want to hear yourself say squeeze.
Two more times. Squeeze. And last one. So you are squeezing right here. Okay, you should really feel it in your triceps. All right, let's do shoulder press. So I'll move over there just to make it easier for you to see me. All right, let's do a press. Arms are here. Pressing with your head and back to the shoulder. So press. So for this one, if you have any shoulder issues, just do what's comfortable. If it's not comfortable for you, then just avoid the exercise. Or do it without weight, then you'll just be working on your range of motion, which is great as well. But for strength, you want to be using weights if you can. Let's do two more. And last one. Excellent. All right, let's put the weights down and work on our legs. So we're going to do some standing exercises. I want to throw these in. Some people have asked, and it really is beneficial. So if you have to do a seated class, full standing class, difficult. This is perfect for people who want to do some standing but can't do it, can't manage a full class. All right, so if you need to be seated, you can stay in your chair. I do this workout at work all the time with the patients that I work with. And some of the patients will decide to stay seated, and that's totally okay. You can still do the exercises, just in a different way. All right, so for those of you who can stand and want to stand, grab onto your chair. You're going to lift those heels as high as you can, and slowly bring them back down. We're working on the strength in the back of our lower legs. Let's do two more after this one. Okay, this time I just want you to lift your toes a little bit and back down. Lift your toes a little bit and down. This is just working on the strength in the front of your legs. My shoes are squeaky. Let's just do one more. Okay. All right, let's do our side raises. So putting all your weight on one side, we are just going to lift the other foot out. So I'm going to angle it. You can see that I'm not going
to angle it.
So you can go about 2 feet out and back in. So we're trying to stay straight.
I'm just going to do this.
And back in. So all your weight's on the other leg. And back in. So working on strengthening the muscles here in our hip.
Try to keep your body straight. If you can.
This can be quite tough, so if you need to stop and then restart again, that's totally fine. Let's just do one more. Alright, give that leg a break. Shake the leg out.
Shake it out.
Put all your weight on the opposite leg and going up to the side. Now, if you have really good balance, you can let go of the chair and do it without, but that's pretty difficult, but if you want to challenge that. And two more on this side. All right, this time we are going to do one a little bit different. We're going to bring the toes back. So toes are touching the floor, and I want you to bring your heel to as close as you can to your glutes, okay? So toes are back, bring that heel up, working on our hamstrings here. Touching the floor, back up again. This one's quite tough. We're just going to do six because it is a lot harder. Excellent. Okay, relax. Now shift those legs out. Other side. So toes are back. Bring that heel up. Touching the floor. Two. Three.
Four.
And let's just do two more on each side. Excellent. Okay, let's do a bit of a balance exercise. We'll bring all our weight on one foot. The other foot is off the floor, letting go of the chair if you can, but have your hand close by in case you need to grab on. Okay, so we're going to hold for 10.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
And put the foot down. Good. Okay, other side. So lifting that foot off, letting go of the chair if you can, or having your hand close by. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And down. Good. Okay, let's do our sit to stance. So, we're going to stand in front of our chair. Different levels here. You can either lift your legs if you want to. If you can, I really encourage you to do as many as you can of these because it's really important to strengthen those legs. So, we're going to stand up. And if you need to, you can put all your weight down and come down. But if you don't need to, then just hover over the chair and up again.
Like if you're in a porta potty, you don't want to sit all the way.
Two.
Because it's nasty in those porta potties. Ah.
Four. Five. Six. So pushing through those heels. Coming up, you're pressing through the heels. Now on this one, when you come over, I want you to squeeze your glutes. So at this point,
squeeze those ass muscles.
Hold for 10, 9,
8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
And relax the glutes. Good. Excellent. All right.
Shake your booty.
We're going to do a little bit more cardio and then we're going to stretch. So just march from those feet.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Back to the march. Okay, let's bring our arms forward. Okay, heels not pressing over the bed. You're all set. We're just going to be stretching after this, and then you'll be done. 30 minutes, roughly. Time always goes by so much faster than I think it's going to. Hopefully it feels that way for you. It's always a good thing when you're exercising. Let's press forward. So please write in the comments, let me know what you would like to see in future workouts. I would like to get feedback from all of you to know what you liked and didn't like. So it would be great to hear from you. All right, let's just slow that down. Just take a deep breath in. And breathing out. Breathing in again. And out. All right, let's bring the arms in front. I'm going to turn my chair and make it a bit easier for you to see. So pressing those hands out front, feeling that in your upper back. All right, let's bring the hands back, feeling that in your chest. If you want to, or if you need to, if you want more of a stretch, you can grab onto the chair and lean forward. Depends on what works best for you. Let's reach one arm over our head as high as you can to the ceiling. Feet are flat on the floor. Let's lean slightly over, feeling that down side. And the other side, reaching up to the ceiling. And then lean over. Good, let's press our arms into the sides. So it's like you're trying to touch the walls here, feeling that stretch in your arms. Bring your fingers down to the floor. Back up again to the ceiling. Bring the arms in front, and you'll feel that stretch in your back again. Press. Excellent. Okay, we're seated on the end of our chair. We'll bring one leg forward. You're hinging at the hips, leaning forward, and feeling that in your hamstrings. This is a fairly intense stretch, but a good one. Switch into the other side, bringing that heel out, hinging at the hips, leaning forward. And sitting up, bringing that heel onto the knee. If that is too challenging, so love you, you can do it behind this one. You can just cross your legs and lean forward. But if you can, bring your ankle onto your knee and you're going to hinge on the hips. So feeling a really good stretch all the way through here. Focusing on our breathing here, so taking in a deep breath. And breathing out. Again, deep breath in. And breathing out. Switch to the other leg, so angle onto the knee, hinging at the hips, leaning forward. Again, taking a deep breath in, and breathing out. One more time, deep breath in, and out. Good. Okay, let's bring our arm in front, finish off with our shoulder and neck stretches. So arm in front, cross it in front of your body, pulling that arm in. You should feel a really good stretch here. So pulling that arm in. Bring that arm down, up to the other side, cross it in front. Not neglect our triceps either. Arm up overhead, drop the hand behind you. So if you're patting yourself on the back, press that elbow back. And if you're prepared to do that, you just relax the other arm. You still feel a really good stretch in the tricep. Excellent. Let's switch to the other side. Arm up overhead, drop the hand behind, pressing that over back. Remembering to breathe. All right, let's finish with our neck stretches. So bringing our ear to our shoulder, feet are flat on the floor here. Just relax into that stretch. Just lift your ears, trying to touch your shoulder, but do not lean over. Sometimes see people doing this. Try to stay upright. It's just your head that is dropping down to the side. Let's slowly rotate our head forward. So slowly bring your head down, but you're trying to rotate it as slowly as you can until you get over to the other side. And hold. In front, just gently look up to the ceiling and then back down to the floor. Slowly look back up again. Let's finish with our three deep breaths, so taking a deep breath in and then breathing up through the mouth. Deep breath in through the nose and breathing. Last one. All right, that's it for today. Thank you so much for joining me. Please write in the comments, as I said before.
Yeah. That was kind of nice. It was a nice sit-down workout. And then tomorrow we're going to get to cardio and we're going to do abs, cardio and abs. So it's going to be fast paced tomorrow. So be there or be square. Yeah, I noticed that it doesn't seem like there's many on when I'm on anymore. Must have been just that week. Yeah, well, you see any gamers? Maybe we should just show some gamers or something. Any of your buddies on? Well, let's see. Who's on right now? Let's see. All right. Let's see. Well, hump day for the bootay is what I see here. Let's see what this person's doing. Hump day for the bootay. The D-Lit is his name. Okay. Back to mine. I'll do this. All right, we're gonna raid this person. He says, hump day for the bootay. That's what he said. So we're gonna see him work his bootay. Okay, folks, God bless. You know, show the love, be kind to one another, because you don't know what other people are going through, okay? Have a good day.